Get ready to match the star. Gene Wood. Brett Summers. Gary Berghoff. Amanda Blake. Richard Dawson. And Joyce Buliffont. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the star of Match Game 74.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Johnny Olson, and thank you, dear friends.
A picture?
Yes. As I see, there's a lady with a sweatshirt on there that says Match Game. Isn't that nice of her to do that in our honor?
Yeah.
Is everybody all ready?
Yes.
Yes.
Have you noticed her naturally rosy lips? Aren't they lovely?
Her naturally rosy lips?
I'm going to get that little blank and kick him so hard.
That'll be enough of that. We're really one big happy family, friends, in spite of what you hear there.
Right.
Now let's say hello to our two players here, Maureen Thompson and Lisa Puglisi. Hello, ladies.
Hello.
This lady has $2,850 to her credit, and as you can see, she's happy about that. And she said she's going to spend it all on herself, and I think that's marvelous.
Not really.
Well, you're going to give the kids a little, aren't you?
A little bit.
Okay.
Well, she's
got seven kids. So, you know, she needs all she can get now. You going to have any more children?
Well, to be very honest with you, five of them are mine and two are stepchildren, but I feel like they're mine. So.
Yeah, I guess you give them a lot of love and all that.
That's enough, I think.
Now, Lisa, where are we here? We just met you last time, didn't we? Did you tell us the story of your life?
Yes, I did.
Well, you want to tell it again?
Okay.
I was fascinated by it.
I'm from Glendale, California, and I'm in nursing school. And I'm really eager to play the match game.
Okay, we're going to play that game right after we play this game with our audience. Here we go. I will push this button with my middle finger and reveal two questions here in round one and ask Lisa to make a selection.
B, please.
Lisa, you want B? There it is. That's what you're going to get. Marge said to the psychiatrist, "My husband's been in the bathtub for 6 weeks. And he says he's never coming out. He thinks he's a blank." You like that, huh?
Yeah.
Aren't you glad you quit that other show and came over here?
I really am.
That's an easy one.
That is an easy one, yeah. I know what I'd say if I were playing, but I can't say that now, you see, because I'm not playing.
Playing, you couldn't say it.
Yes, I could.
Tell us that joke again.
I got
your
another
mother
one.
Oh, heaven.
Go ahead. No, don't let me. Does it disturb you if I look over your shoulder?
It disturbs me when you don't.
The whole question here, well, I'll read it to you again in a second or so. Now, just to put it in the slot there, and away we go. Marge said to the psychiatrist, "My husband's in the bathtub for 6 weeks. He says he's never coming out. He thinks he's a blank."
Fish.
Fish. Okay. That's all right. She says he thinks he's a fish.
Mm-hmm. What do you? Pardon me?
What do you say he thinks he is?
it's funny you should ask that. He thinks that he is a seal. That's
a seal.
What I put down.
Okay.
Seal.
There is a good response. That's not bad. Now don't.
That's a big fish.
That's a big fish.
Yeah.
No, a seal.
Is
a
mammal.
Is a mammal, yeah.
Yes.
Right. All right, Brett, what do you say?
What are you, honey? That's what I say.
I'm a man.
A stout-hearted man.
No.
Now, is a whale a fish or
no,
a mammal?
No, a whale is a mammal. Yeah.
I had that. Oh, stop that.
Stop buzzing that lady. Can't you give her another sound? She's just tired of hearing it. She hears it over and over again because she's so dumb. That's right. No, I'm only sad. Didn't mean that there. What do you say?
That's a very good answer. I wish I had thought of that.
Well, we're going to be
no,
one of those
when
days.
You're in the water that long, you shrivel up, and he thought he was a prune.
A prune.
Not only that.
That's a long time in the water. All right,
you
Amanda.
You were a prune, that's where you'd be.
She is looking for the answer, fish.
There is only one way to go on that.
Really?
Fish.
There's one for you, Lisa. Would you give that lady a fish?
Well, I certainly will. That seal must have eaten it. I had a fish when I came in.
Now, if you'd ask for a rubber chicken, he'd have it.
I know Marge's husband very well.
Oh, you did know
He's
him?
A beautiful human being.
Right.
Came to our house and sat in our bathroom for 6 weeks.
6 weeks in the bathroom?
Silly person.
Yeah.
Thought he was a mermaid.
Oh!
So the time just blew away.
Yes. Time flies when you're in the bubbly.
I know.
Likely tale.
Can I Joyce? Tell you about another friend of my mother's?
A friend of your mother's?
Yeah, she has a bathtub, and she keeps it filled with goldfish. And I said to her one day, well, what do you do when you take a bath? And she said, I blindfold them. Goldfish.
Goldfish. Two for you. Not bad for a first-round question. Now, Maureen, let's see how you do with your first-round question. Consuela said, Dr. Welby told me never to look inside his closet. And now I know why. He keeps a blank in there. Dr. Welby does. Maureen, for you. Consuela said, Dr. Welby told me never to look inside his closet, and now I know why. He keeps a blank in there.
Hi, honey.
Mm-hmm. You got yours?
Yeah, I got it, Jane.
You got yours?
Oh, I got it.
Attaboy.
Oh, you got
yours. You doing a feature-length movie or a movie for television or something
like that? It's a little thing in Tijuana. Black mask and body makeup. Should be a lot of fun.
Well, if you need the black mask, what are you growing the beard for?
Just for the heck of it.
All right. Come on, Amanda. Really? Okay. You're sure about that?
Yeah. Oh. I heard the joke.
All right. Maureen, Consuela said Dr. Welby told me never to look inside his closet, and now I know why. He keeps a blank in there. What do you say to that?
A woman?
Okay.
I do terrible on these.
Old Dr. Welby. Old Dr. Welby?
Well, that's what made him old.
That's what made him old. Yeah.
How about an old lady?
You know, have you ever seen him walk? He goes like this when he's running.
Oh,
that's as fast as he can go. What did you
Before
say?
Before he got that girl in the closet, he did the mile in 4 minutes.
How about Dr. Welby, Gene?
So the guy comes up to the doctor's office, he knocks on the door, the nurse opens up the door, the guy says, is the doctor in? And the nurse says, no, come on in. Okay.
Right.
Now that we've won them
seriously,
over.
Seriously, folks.
I said nurse in the
nurse.
Closet.
Hey. No.
Oh, it's a woman person.
Well, hold on.
Isn't she a woman?
Change of mind.
Yes. Terrific.
You sure about that?
Yes.
Male nurse? Never heard of him. Okay.
No.
Plenty
okay.
of male nurses.
Yep.
Is that
right.
be chauvinistic
All right.
about
just
this?
Just want to make sure you know what you're doing over there.
Right. Okay, I'm sorry. I know the girl.
What?
Well, this is little known information about Dr. Welby, but he happens to be an extremely patriotic person.
Yes.
And he keeps a sailor in there.
Oh. Oh, that's why he walks slow.
Yeah.
All right.
You got it.
Gary, I don't even know what I'm talking about.
Yo, yes, you do.
No, I don't, Gary. You little rascal. Show us your answer.
You see, he was getting old.
Yeah.
He did have a woman in there, but he was getting so old he forgot her, and now she's just a skeleton.
Skeleton. Since you kept a woman skeleton in there, what do you say about Dr. Welby?
Well, I say he's wonderful. I've been to him. Yes, he's terrific.
Oh, really? Did he cure your problem?
All the way.
Oh, good. I'm so happy.
Okay. I'm sure this must match. Girl cadaver?
Now, wait a minute. Let him think about it for a minute. Girl cadaver.
No?
No? No, she...
Well, a cadaver's not an alive
The judge
person.
Says no.
Okay.
She said woman. Now, what do you say?
What's the question again?
The question is this.
Well, I like
Dr.
to set
Welby,
him up.
Dr. Yeah. Welby told me never to look inside his closet. Never now I know why. He keeps a blank in there.
Should never look inside the closet.
Never look inside the closet.
Why?
He keeps a, why?
Because he keeps a dress in there. That's for when he goes out at night.
Yes.
Terribly
what
naughty.
Size? Listen. All right, Joyce.
But that's only because when you're examining the patient, a nurse has to be present.
I see. Oh, I see. He puts a dress on, pretends he's a nurse. All right, Joyce.
Oh, I just said he's always so successful that he keeps a dead patient in there.
Come on, these are
the bunch
jokes,
of weirdos
folks.
Here. All right, so at this moment, the score is 2-1 in favor of Lisa. That's the end of round one. And what comes after round one? Round two, but first. Here, score is 2-1 in favor of our challenger. And now we go to round two, and I ask our challenger to make a selection.
I'll go with B again.
B. Now, last time, Lisa, you matched Amanda and Joyce, and the two of you will not participate in this. Everyone else will. Sally is so cheap.
How cheap is
how
Sally?
Cheap is she?
I'll tell you how cheap she is.
Yep.
She's got a payphone in her living room and a parking meter next to her blank. That's how cheap Sally is.
That's a real.
Aren't you sorry you're not playing this one?
I sure am. Yeah. I think it's a good thing we're not playing, Amanda.
All right. You finished, Gary. Yes, you did. Okay, here we go. Lisa Puglisi. Sally is so cheap. She's got a payphone in her living room and a parking meter next to her blank.
Her bed.
Her bed, she says. I see. You know Sally, don't you? The way you're cheering and screaming and hollering. What do you say about Sally, Gino?
Well, I happen to know Sally very well. I spent an evening with her. Things were going along terrifically, and then I ran out of change. Next to her bed.
There it is. That's one for you. What did you say?
I say 2 down and 1 to go.
Drop back and punt.
I said bam.
Good. That's 2 beds for you, Lisa. Oh, there's another bed for Lisa Puglisi. Now, let's see. We come down here to Richard.
Present. Well, his quick naps are great.
How about you, hairy faced fellow?
I know that lady very well.
You know that? Oh, you know Sally. She's so cheap, she's got a payphone in her living room and a parking meter next to her blank.
I was there necking with her.
Really?
Flag came up, said violation. That's the joke he was looking for. Ben.
Hey, Richard.
Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Maureen. You got your work cut out for you. You got to match 5 to stay in the game. I mean, you got to get everybody to stay in the game here. The only one not playing is Gene Wood. Here we go. Santa Claus said, what a rotten Christmas Eve.
How rotten how Christmas rotten Eve was.
This is, I'll tell you how rotten a Christmas Eve was. The first house I went to, they had a fire in the fireplace, and coming down the chimney, I nearly burned my blank off. That's how rotten Christmas Eve is.
Would you repeat that question?
No, I'm not going to repeat the question. Just write whatever you think comes into your mind. No. Santa Claus said, what a rotten Christmas Eve. The first house I went to, they had a fire in the fireplace, and coming down the chimney, I nearly burned my blank off.
You got that question from Scrooge.
Hello, darling.
I think that... Oh, that's nice.
The wire. Can't you think of anything?
So far, okay. She hasn't thought, period.
All right, so there's ready. He's ready. Of course, he's always ready.
And, just say it away.
Okay, Maureen Thompson. Santa Claus said, what a rotten Christmas Eve. The first house I went to, they had a fire in the fireplace. And coming down the chimney, I nearly burned my blank off.
Please, bottom. Please.
Please, bottom?
Bottom.
Burned his please bottom off.
Wazoo. Yeah.
Okay. All right. Gotta match everybody. Brett, you are first.
First what? I didn't understand what that little thing said over there.
What
thing? Please, bottom.
That
she said
little
bottom.
Girl.
Bottom.
She said bottom.
Bottom is her answer.
Oh, for goodness gracious sakes, and to think I said buns.
Buns and bottom.
That's it?
That's
yeah,
a match.
You got it. Yeah.
Okay, there's one. Gary?
You can't burn off Santa Claus's bottom.
Why?
Everyone knows he wears asbestos jammies.
He does.
But his beard burns.
His beard burns.
So Lisa wins the game.
Congratulations. Okay, now you stand by for a moment or so here. We got to say goodbye to Maureen, but she's leaving with a smile on her face. Isn't that nice? She's got $2,850. Goodbye, Maureen. What a nice lady that is with seven kids, and I'm glad she's got some money. Because she will know what to do with it, because she's a good-hearted lady. Now, we're going to have a go at the big money super match here with this lady right after this message. There's nothing to be scared of. Is there anything to be scared of?
Yes.
What?
Yes. If I were her age and you had your arm around me, honey, I'd be terrified.
All right. Shall I take my arm away from your shoulder?
Yes.
No.
I don't know.
You don't know?
I think you got it now, Gene.
You must be a lot of laughs on a date. Listen, shall we have a go at this, Lisa?
Uh-huh.
Okay, what do you want to have a go at? All right, we'll have a go. I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to play the big money super match here, and this is the way it goes, Lisa. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Moving blank.
Oh.
Now, the answer that group gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. Now, if you match the next one, you get $250. If you match a bottom one, you get $100. Now, three of these ding-a-lings are allowed to help. Which three would you like to get a little assist from?
Richard.
Hey, hold it. Just hold it a second before you give your answer. Dinah Shore is taping next door, and she's got the USC marching band, the Trojans, on there. Can you hear them?
I can hear
them. Let's all be quiet and see if they can pick it up with the microphone.
Oh, that's just...
What are you saying? We all march into the Dinah Shore studio next door. We gotta go on with this, but it really is so loud. I figured those people at home better know what that funny noise is and make sure there's nothing wrong with their TV set. What'd you
say?
That's
not a band.
That's not a band?
No, dinosaurs really do make a lot of noise like
dinosaurs
that.
Dinosaurs make a lot of noise. They're marching around there. Anyway, we'll go on with this. Now, which was the first one you named?
Richard,
all right.
Well, what I would get charged with if you and I went out on a date. A moving violation.
Moving violation.
Sure.
Okay, there's one.
Amanda.
Moving van.
Moving van. All right, you've got two.
And Brett.
Brett.
I'm torn between two.
What?
I think I'm going to say Target.
Moving Target. Okay, so you've got moving...
Like that, I could have said day.
Moving day. All right, moving target, moving van, moving violation. You may choose one of those, Lisa, or you can think up one of your own if you'd like. What would you like to do?
I think I'll go with van.
Moving van?
Serious, moving on.
Moving on?
Yeah, but I'd rather go with van.
Okay, moving van is
like
what Lisa
van.
Wants.
He's
and let's
nice.
Find out if it's up there now, and if it's there,
yeah,
where
it
is
quickly,
it?
Quickly, the buffalo are coming.
Yes. I mean, it's really noisy. I repeat again for those of you who might have just tuned in.
For a minute, Dinah I thought Shore was
standing next door, and she's got the USC marching band on, the Trojans there, and they're playing and doing their thing, and it's making a heck of a racket in our studio. And we're going to stop it, Dinah? Okay, here we go. We're looking for moving van, and may we see the $100 response. Moving target is up there, the one that Brett gave you. That may be a good omen, Lisa. That's still looking for a moving van. Here is a $250 response. Moving on. That's the one you mentioned, isn't it? Okay, last chance for moving van. Here is the $500 response. Moving van, you got it. Congratulations. Atta girl. Okay. Now, I guess I got to keep my eye my arm around you because you keep wanting to fall back there on the stairs, and I don't want you to do that. I want you to stay here with me.
You're so
You've
kind.
Got the $500. You're up to $600. You got a chance at $5,000 to collect. You got to match one celebrity. Which one will it be?
I'll go with Richard.
Okay, Richard, you get ready to write. You face me, Lisa.
Yes.
Here it is. The $5,000 question. Blank Paradise. Blank Paradise. Paradise, P-A-R-A-D-I-S-E, paradise. All right, he's finished. Now, Lisa, how do you fill in that blank in order to match his answer? Blank paradise.
Oh, I can't think of anything. Wait a second. Oh.
Okay, would the band play another number while she's... Dinah, would you get the band to play while she's thinking?
No, but I could march.
Blank paradise. We have to call for an answer.
Fantastic.
Fantastic paradise. You did.
All right, Richard, gonna write that.
May we see your answer, please?
Yeah, bird of paradise.
Bird of paradise. Yeah. Hey, did you ever hear that?
Yeah.
You've heard of the bird of paradise. Yeah, that is kind of a tough one, but a bird of paradise is the only answer I could think of. Well, I'm sorry you didn't think of it, but Lisa, you've got $600, and that's all yours. You're gonna play another game later, but right now we've got this for you. We just have a second to thank you and to thank you. And join us next time for Match Game 74. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Goodson, Bill Chapman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.